The best way to get to Blarney Castle is to walk there. To walk there, I mean, from the town of Cork. You will go to Padraic's Bridge. You will walk along the quays. You will pass Shandon Church, whose bells a poet has made famous. You will come to a second bridge. Then you will turn up Blarney Street. You will go on until you come to a place named Clochene, and the valley which Blarney Castle dominated is then before you. But you should stay for a while upon Padraic's Bridge and take in the scene and the people. Across the way is Shandon Church with its turret. White and brown is Shandon steeple, party coloured like the people. Two sides of the turret are of white stone, two of brown stone. The white stone is used again in the embankment of the river. The Lee flows along the quays of limestone. This is the central part of Cork. You then go on and a long street that begins in an undistinguished part of the town and ends in a lane. And then you are out of the town and in the county of Cork. Clochene, meaning the little stones, is not a village. There is a church there and a few houses, a pump, and that is all. And the road to Blarney is before you. I go to Blarney by the fields that are the greenest of all the green fields of Erin. Yonder field is a green mirror for the clouds to make shadows upon. And I pass a field that is yellow dandelions and grass so soft and smooth that I think that only the cattle of a king have any right to graze there. No other cattle would be worthy of such a sward. Passing these fields, I come to Blarney village with its factory, a dull little place. And then I go through the gate and enter the grounds of Blarney's old castle, grounds overgrown with shrubs. Near the gate, under the trees, with a shawl over her head for shelter from the showers, is a simple-faced old woman. She returns my salutation, and I go over and talk to her. She has a rambling mind. She likes the air here, and she likes to watch the flowing water. She does not say it to me, but I gather from her rambling illusions that she nurses the hope that some of the visitors will make her some sort of offering, something that would give her an allowance for tea or snuff. And over again, she tells me that she likes to watch the flowing water from where she sits. There are handsome trout in that stream that never were caught and that never can be caught. She tells me a legend of the castle that has as much to recommend its authenticity as any of the half dozen legends that are current. And as I go away from her, she says, "May God carry you every road safe." The keep is built on a shelf of rock that dominates the valley. I go to the top, about 100 feet up, and there I come upon a group who are not ordinary visitors. A personage whom I take to be an Indian prince is kissing the stone by proxy. A servitor is hanging down the wall to lip it. From the top of the keep, I look on the green lawns that are all around me. Blarney has nothing to show better than these, except perhaps a yew tree that grows out of a tier of rock on which the castle is built. It bends outward, and some of its branches grow towards the ground. Others are bare. The branches that are lifted up have constant movement like waves, dark green, feathery branches waving against rock and wall. There it grows, blended somehow with rock and ruin, like some unused image that has come spontaneously into a poet's verse. The legend of the castle that my old woman told me had to do with water and a fairy woman. and although the woman in it is old, not young, the story, I imagine, is part of the widely spread story of the water maiden, Undine, or Melusina. The King of Monsters saved an old woman who was about to drown in the lake. She had nothing to give him by way of reward. She told him, however, that if he would mount the topmost wall of his castle and kiss a stone which she described to him, he would gain speech that would win friend or foe to him, man or woman. There is the lake that might well be the scene for the encounter with the Melusina or the Undine. It's about a mile from the castle. But, as a friend who meets me here, a poet and a scholar reminds me, Blarney was famous for its groves before the stone and its lake were ever heard of. The place name itself means groves, and as for its groves, that Blarney is celebrated in what is the most diverting of Irish poems, the Groves of Blarney, which was made up to parody a song made in schoolmaster's English in the 18th century. The structure and the sound of Gaelic poetry are reproduced in it. The ah sound of Blarney is woven through every stanza. But every word that has the sound seems to have gone into its place smilingly. The groves of Blarney, they are so charming, down by the purling of sweet silent streams, being banked with posies that spontaneous grows there, planted in order by the sweet rock close. 'Tis there the daisy and the sweet carnation, the blooming pink and the rose so fair, the daffodown dilly, likewise the lily, all flowers that scent the sweet fragrant air. There's gravel walks there for speculation and conversation in sweet solitude, and there the lover may hear the dove or the gentle plover in the afternoon. And if a lady would be so engaging as to walk alone in these shady bowers, 'tis there the courtier he may transport her into some fort or all underground. For 'tis there's a cave where no daylight enters, but cats and badgers are forever bred, being moss by nature that makes it sweeter than a coach and six or a feather bed. And there the lake is, well stored with perches and comely eels by the verdant mud, beside the leeches and groves of beeches standing in order for to guard the flood. There are statues gracing this noble place in all heathen gods and nymphs so fair, bold Neptune, Plutarch and Nicodemus, all standing naked in the open air. So now to finish this brief narration, which my poor genius could not entwine, but were I Homer or Nebuchadnezzar, 'tis every feature I would make it twine. This is the poem which James Stevens told me once he would rather have written than anything in an Irish anthology.